kayaking are great forms of exercise. You not only challenge your core strength, but you're working your upper body and your cardiovascular system as well. Plus, it's a beautiful way to spend your day with some outdoor nature. So I'd like to show you some exercises to prepare your body for your next adventure. So let's go ahead and learn the exercise for the power paddleboarding workout. Having upper body strength is so very important. So we're gonna focus on using the upper body strength by initiating it from the core. So the first exercise is a static chest press. So you're gonna face away from your tower, come to a seated position, and you're gonna keep the glide board in one place as you go into the chest press. Now you can change the angle by lifting it up higher or going down lower, but wherever you do, try to get some speed in the motion, or you can take it really slow by really isolating through your core or even adding some rotation. Now to work the reverse motion, go into static rows. Face your tower and come into a seated position. Keep your back straight, your core engaged, and lift up through your legs. As you do this, you're gonna go into that row. Now you can keep your torso straight or you can add that rotation. So you can go for speed or you can really slow it down, trying to keep the glide board still at all times. You'll stay facing the tower for arm circles. Now your legs can go into a crisscross applesauce position. You can keep them straight out, or you can go into kneeling position. The whole idea here is to really start to use your shoulders in all ranges of motion. So as we do this, we're circling out and around, but we're really trying to use the core, the power from it, have it initiate the movement as you circle around. And then you'll reverse the motion, pressing back, scooping out and around, and again, initiating from your core, keeping your spine straight at all times. This will really help you whenever you're paddling upstream. Then you'll flip it around with your back facing the tower for the same movement of arm circles. Now this has a different feel because now you're facing away on an incline. It's a little easier, and you'll know what I mean once you start to perform this. So again, you can keep your legs crossed, legs extended, or come into a kneeling position, but be sure to do this in both directions. Your core is so important because all the power that you're using to paddle upstream comes from it. So we're gonna attach the ab crunch accessory to focus on your core. I lifted up the incline, so wherever your strength level is, that's where you place the incline. Come into a kneeling position, keep your core engaged, shoulders relaxed and down. And you're just gonna tuck your knees all the way in by activating through your core, bringing your hips towards your ribs. That's what I want you to think about. And as you do this, exhale your breath each time. Then you'll turn the knees to the side to work in through your obliques. And of course, you'll do both sides. Then you'll come into a plank position. So keep the glide board open, your core is engaged, shoulder blades are down and back. Make sure you're not dipping through your hips. So keep everything nice and in line. And you're just gonna shift forward and back, bringing your head towards the tower. This will strengthen not only your core, but also through your shoulders. This is such a great movement to really work through your powerhouse, to keep your core engaged and get you ready to get on the water. Paddleboarding not only challenges your upper body and your core, but you need some leg strength as well. So we're gonna incorporate the cyclone trainer to give you a little cardiovascular exercise whenever you need to bring the kayak or the canoe in and out of the water. So this will really help train for that. So you're gonna come down for cycled sprint bursts. The first one's gonna be a minute. So you'll lie down, have the incline at a high level, and you're gonna go as fast as you can for 1 minute. Once 1 minute is done, you'll sit up, have a nice relaxed pace to recover your body and your breath. Keep your back nice and straight, keep your core engaged. And if you want, you can kind of add a little rotation into that motion of your legs. Once 1 minute is up, you're going back down for 45 seconds. So go at it, keep your body going. Go as fast as you can, trying to really burst through some speed intervals. And then once the 45 seconds is done, you'll come back up into a slower pace again, using your core, using your legs to relax, recover. You can add that rotation again, and then you have one more burst for 30 seconds. So come back down, go at it for 30 seconds, And again, once that 30 seconds is up, come back down into your seated position and recover again. You can repeat that cycle as many times as you'd like, and you'll go through all of these exercises in the series 2 to 3 times, 10 reps each. Good luck, and I wish you the best on your next kayak or canoeing adventure.
First time I'm trying out the cycle trainer. It's an excellent accessory for the Total Gym. I use the Total Gym all the time, and I've been waiting for something that could use my legs a little bit more to get some cardio, and this is just a wonderful accessory that you can use whether you're a kayaker and you're out to canoe or any kind of sport. Very versatile. If you don't have a bike or treadmill, you got to have a cycle trainer.